case of nursing management with the post op patients at the MISC. MISC is the multi-system implemented system in the child. And I'm going to present the case of 1 year, 5 month male child diagnosed as multiple VSD and PAPVC, and surgery was done for the same. And the POD file, he showed the features of MISC like rashes and face and elevated markers. For that patient was treated with IVIG, steroids, antibiotics with effective compassionate nursing care to the patient and family, and discharged from the hospital on 25th POD. The history of the baby is a third by birth order born for NCM couple, and history of fever and pneumonia and hospitalization for 12 days. At the age of 4 months, he was diagnosed with multiple VSD and PAPVC.
Shubha, you are sharing the screen.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The hospital course of the patient is electively he is taken for surgery and shifted to ICU with ventilator and inotropic support and extubated after 19 hours of ventilator. The patient had fever and at POD5 developed in maculopapular rashes over the face and irritable tongue. The palpable cervical lymph nodes and chapped cheeks, and for the which we are sent in COVID antibody, and the report showed negative, positive, and RT-PCR negative, hence the child was isolated. The echo showed dilated coronaries and pleural and mild pericardial effusion, and child was treated with steroids, methylprednisolone, and IVIG 2 gram per kg we have given for 48 hours, and antiplatelet aspirin was given for over the 6 month of period, and blood culture report were showed no growth. Child had a fungal infection of tinea and treated with the antifungal and anti-helminthic drugs. The labs values showed elevated level of D-dimer with this 10% and the ferritin and LDH and CRP also is elevated. And the images, the echo shows dilated coronaries of LMCA and mild pleural and pericardial effusions. The main challenges for this taking care of babies, explaining and getting the parents to accept is very difficult due to inadequate knowledge about the new diseases. And because it's a new presenting signs and symptoms, MISC can be mistaken for viral illness or gastroenteritis. MISC is a newly characterized syndrome, and its an optimal treatment is currently unknown. The fear of staff to take care or hesitation to staff to take care of the patient because risk of self-exposure and carrying the infection to the home. Example, myself is having 1 year-old baby. When I'm taking care of COVID-positive patients, after coming, I have to take a great job to prevent infection for my son. And this nursing intervention is the backbone of our health system. The applying nursing diagnosis for our patients are impaired cardiac tissue perfusion related to the coronary dilatation, in which we have done monitoring of vitals and urine output and documented as early and maintained the oxygen therapy as ordered. And assess signs of pallor and signs of mottling or cold or clammy skin and quality of pulse and other indications for the cardiac dysfunctions. For the hypothermia related to the COVID infections, for the fever, we have managed with tepid sponging. If fever is more than 100, we give injection paracetamol and manage with other measures of fever things. The fluid volume deficit secondary to hypothermia. The child was fed every second early and maintained strict intake output chart. And the fourth diagnosis, nursing diagnosis, imbalanced nutrition less than body requirements related to the poor intake and secondary to mucosal injury as the patient had irritable red tongue. For that, we have ascertained the healthy body weight, height and weight for the age and maintained good oral hygiene and dentition and offered high protein supplements such as eggs, B protein powder as the thrice in a day and multivitamins, all the amino acids and multivitamins which are added in the oral supplements. Risk of transmitting infections. This is the main thing which we have to follow during pandemic. The prevention of infection is a very important role as a nurse. For that, we have maintained a strict hand hygiene, followed universal precautions, single nursing to prevent cross contaminations, and strict isolation was maintained. And the sixth is impaired skin integrity related to the rashes. They maintained good hygiene and applied Ebonet lotions for this rashes and because of the COVID, and the fungicross cream and absorb powder for this antifungal treatment. And the parents counseling. This is the most difficult part while the baby is having COVID in the ICU, which is along with cardiac issues. The patient parents were so much of anxious, and for that daily counseling of parents was done and explained prognosis of their clinical features on daily basis. The diversional therapy was given to the parents by engaging in chakra therapy. It is very good in our hospital, and encourage the parents to be vaccinated for COVID as soon as possible, and advise not to vaccinate the child for 11 months from the date of discharge as IVIG was given. The conclusion, so far we have diagnosed the baby as much as earlier because of fifth POD, it seemed, showed the features of MISC, and we have given effective treatment, and needs-based care was delivered throughout the hospital stay. And the psychological support was given to the parents with appropriate health education prior to discharging the baby safe to home. As this is a new pediatric affliction, much is yet to be learned, but about a long-term prognosis, and further research is need to create a uniform and effective nursing care. As this MIC as a new affliction, we have to we need more research to be prevent babies further damaging of organs and further deterioration. We have to do a research, and we have to plan an effective and optimal nursing care. And once again, thank you for PCSA to giving the opportunity to present on this topic.
Thank you very much. Great job.